For the last, you know, 5 or 6 years, I've been snowboarding nonstop, summer and winter, without any breaks really. And for the last year and a half, I've kind of slowed that schedule down a little bit to try out different things in life. You know, golfing, scuba diving, seeing this country that I live in. And by doing that, it's kind of gave me, you know, a new appreciation for life and also for snowboarding, and it really made me look at snowboarding and how much I really love to do it, which gave me a new fire inside to go out there and do something that I love to do. One thing that really means a lot to me is having such a really good group of friends that ride for LibTech and GNU that are really good friends as well. And it means a lot to me when we do travel, get a chance to travel together and go to trips like Japan for a promotional trip. It's not so much like a business snowboarding trip as it is a chance to hang out with good friends and have a really good time. And to me, that means a lot. One thing that really makes me happy now is knowing that I have a nice house and a nice art studio, so when I'm not traveling and snowboarding, that I could have a good place to come home to that's comfortable. That really makes me have an ease of mind to really focus on the things that I love to do, like art, like being with my family. For me, what's important is putting into perspective life, not just single-mindedly snowboarding every day, all the time, but to balance that out with the other things that I've never done in life. You know, might be travel, might be meeting new people, it might be going to different museums and learning about this world that I live in. To me, that's just as important as strapping on that snowboard right now. But it also balances it out, so when I do strap on that snowboard, I really appreciate what I do. I appreciate where it's gotten me. And it's something that I'll always do for the rest of my life. We'll be right back.
Have you ever heard of Jason Brown?
No.
No? You ever heard of the snowboarder Jason Brown? Yeah. Oh, Jason. Jason Brown.
Jason Brown.
You guys know Jason Brown?
Yeah.
What do you think of Jason Brown?
Pretty cool. He's cool.
Yeah. Yeah, what about his hair?
It's cool.
Yeah, it's cool.
It's crazy.
Jason Brown. Guess what? It's starting. You ready?
Oh.
Have you guys seen a volcano around here? Trying to go snowboarding? All right, thanks.
Jason, wait up. Hey, Jason, wait up. Oh, there you are. I thought you were.
Dad's from around here?
Nope.
From?
Salt Lake City.
Salt Lake City.
Super good surfing. He probably was gonna
do that
anyway.
The cool hair dye?
In Vancouver. See, now he's asking dumb questions.
You call me dumb? I'm just fingernails are dumb.
I was just kidding, man. All I wanted was my ticket. It's cool. 1-800-FLOWERS. FLOWERS. Only just begun. And then, happy birthday, baby. B-A-B-Y.
Hey, aunties, your mother laid out for you.
Panties, made out. Panties, you mother.
No panties.
No panties. No panties. No panties. Your mother made us. Made us.
Nice.
Bye.
drinking that whiskey, 96 proof. Don't need no doctor, don't feel no pain. My leg's just two steps ahead of my brain. This cat, it's on a hot tin roof. This cat, you're gonna shake it loose. This cat, don't get the blues. This cat shaking on a hot tin roof. On a hot tin roof. He's on a hot tin roof, jumping up and down like a long-necked goose. Shimmy and shake, baby, you can't fail. Rock so hard that it's off of the scale. This cat is on a hot tin roof. This cat is gonna shake you loose. This cat, don't get the blues, cause this cat shaking on a hot tin roof. This cat is on a hot tin roof. This cat is gonna shake you loose. This cat, don't get the blues, this cat shaking on a hot tin roof.
Jason, here's that shaving cream that you requested.
Thanks, Dave. This is Bobby Meeks. I'm good for
Foster, all you gotta do is get off the couch, buddy, and you'll get the couch.